Welcome back to Living Life's Adventures. On this adventure, my mum, Susan, and my dad, William, came to visit me here in Zambia.
Ons het hier by Lusaka geland by Frank en na sy huis toe en toe ons dinsdagoggend gery van hier af na die Eastern Highway D4 en so oos gery oor die Luangwa rivier en by Toka verby en Katete tot by Chipata daar by Malawi en Mozambique en toe ons west gedraai op na Mfewe toe.
We left Lusaka at 3 o'clock on a Tuesday morning. The first bit of the road from Lusaka to about 50 kilometers before you hit the Luangwa Bridge is okay. The 50 kilometers just before the Luangwa Bridge is pretty bad, but from the Luangwa Bridge all the way to Chipata, the road is in a really good state and we made good ground. From Chipata to Mfui, the road deteriorated a little bit again and we had to go a little bit slower. My dad was a superior map man on my left-hand side, keeping us up to date with route information from the Tracks for African Zambia guidebook. All in all, with a few coffee stops in between, it took us 11 hours with a Land Cruiser and a trailer in tow to the wildlife camp in Mfui, where we would spend the next 4 days. At the wildlife camp, we were fortunate enough to get one of the river stands. This is campsite number 9. Each campsite has a power point, a fire pit, a braai area, and a thatched roof with a table and a couple of benches to enjoy breakfast or dinner on. The ablution blocks at the wildlife camp is shared ablution blocks, but we were pleased to report that every time we used the ablution blocks, everything was clean and tidy. The monkeys, though, are sneaky little buggers at this camp. You have to be on the lookout for opportunistic little monkeys all hours of the day. After setting up camp and settling in, it was time for sunset drinks. Day one of our trip ended with a rather spectacular sunset. Early on day two of our trip, we left the wildlife camp back to the main road and went left and over the bridge that took us into the park. On this day, we explored the southwestern part of the park. The park entry fees is $25 per person per day for international visitors, $20 per person per day for residents and SADC members, and 41 kwacha 70 for Zambian citizens. There's also a charge of $30 if you're driving yourself through the national park. After a very, very nice morning game drive, it was time for breakfast. Breakfast on the Luangwa River.
Hi, donkey friend. Oh, for your
young friend. Oh, my slide.
Thank you.
After a long day of exploring the South Luangwa National Park, it was time for sundowners with my two very special guests. We didn't have any super awesome great sightings, but all in all, we did enjoy the day, and it was fantastic to get to know this beautiful, beautiful park a little bit better. After our sundowners and relaxing for a little bit, we packed up and head back to the wildlife camp where we had a lovely dinner. On day three of our adventure, we woke up early again at the wildlife camp and we made our way back to the bridge, paid our entry fees, and then we went northeast in the park. Breakfast time.
Can't wait. Can't wait for the kids.
The South Luangwa National Park truly is a beautiful, beautiful park with many, many different landscapes and biospheres that changes constantly while you're driving around in the park. The roads this time of the year was well maintained and it made it very easy to get around. You just have to watch out for the sandy bits. We left the park around lunchtime that day because I had to go to the airport to go and pick Sally up. Needless to say, my brain wasn't really with it for the rest of the day. I actually lost the camera and we did however have a wonderful evening and a beautiful sunset again and enjoy the sounds of the night on the shores of the Luangwa. On day four of our adventure, we left the wildlife camp early again and we went back out to the road, the main road, and we took a right this time and followed a road parallel to the Luangwa River all the way up to the Nsefu sector. Now, the Nsefu sector is a big triangle that is on the northeast side of the Luangwa National Park, and we went to go and explore the area up here. This little segment is actually a very interesting segment of the yellow-billed stork. There's a video or documentary that was made called The Leopard's Legacy in this area of a leopard that got accustomed to hunting these storks in their breeding colony. It was interesting to bump into these birds, seeing them hunting and gathering food first, then saw them flying around, and then found the nesting colony where all the chicks were. This was the first of many African butterfly coffee shops, or should I say coffee stops. We made it our mission to find nice spots to stop at with a view or something special for lunch, breakfast or coffee stops. Back at camp that night, we had to get our stuff together because the next morning we would leave really, really early to drive all the way back to Lusaka. Or that was the plan, at least. I'll tell you more about this a little bit later.
Volgende dag het ons van daar af gery weer terug oor Zapata, weer the Eastern Highway tot by Unyanya. Over the Luangwa River, it was south gedraai and afgegaan all langs Mozambique af. Door daar by die brug het ons regs gedraai. Toe gaan ons by Janeiro oos na die Lower Zambezi Nationale Park.
Pulled off the road for a quick coffee.
It's cold.
It's cold. Krijg ons maar koud.
The much needed caffeine at this coffee stop inspired a very interesting idea that turned out to be a raging adventure. So we were supposed to go back to Lusaka on this day, but Sally suggested we enter the Lower Zambezi National Park from the east side. And when adventure is on the plate, I'm there. I just had to convince my mum that it's a good idea. It did take a little bit of convincing. With everyone on board, we took a left turn at the Luangwa Bridge, followed the border and the river down all the way, almost to Luangwa Town, and just before Luangwa Town, we took a right turn and entered the Lower Zambezi National Park from the east side. The road in from the east almost heads directly west. It's a long and slow road, but it's not nearly as bad as I expected.
Quick bush shower.
Nee, dit is nie 'n shower nie, wat is dit? Frank, as jy dit in die openbaar publiek maak, is dit moeilik. Ek onterf jou.
That night we made camp on a sandbank in one of the big rivers. My mom was totally out of her comfort zone. But when the fire was lit and all of us got comfortable, we had a very, very special evening.
Welkom by my kampplek.
Dankie.
Baie baie dankie dat ons die voorreg het om die eerste gas te op jou kamp te
en vir jouself, want jy is eerste op jou kamplek.
And ja. Congratulations for
finding
Nemo.
The next morning we had a early and rather chilly start to the day. Everything was a big mess in the car and around the campsite because of the time we had to set up camp last night, but we all had a nice coffee, enjoyed the brisk air of the morning in the Lower Zambezi, and we packed up and we made our way into the Lower Zambezi National Park. The last 2 days took us from the very east side of the Lower Zambezi National Park to the very west side of the Lower Zambezi National Park. The gate at the west side is the Chongwe River Gate. It goes into the park. That's where we exited. We crossed the Chongwe River. This is the Chongwe River we're crossing right now. and made our way through the GMA. GMA is a game management area, to Mvu River Lodge, where we spent the next 4 days. And at Mvu River Lodge, we've met Antoinette and Dani with their two kids, Ruben and Emma, who extended a heartwarming welcome when we arrived at Mvu.
Hello followers or fans, this was our trip around Lower Zambezi. We also lived in a camp called Mvu. We saw lots of animals, we saw lots of elephants, lots of impalas. When we came back, we saw jackals and bush bugs. And we had some elephants, jackals and hyenas by our camp. But we didn't see any lion. I hope you like this video.
The campsites at Mvu are absolutely fantastic. Each campsite has its own ablution block with a toilet, a basin and a shower. The showers always have nice hot water and the showers and toilets get cleaned every day. Each camp stand also has a wash-up area and a fire pit and some basic furniture you can use while you are there. The camp also provide a bundle of firewood per day. When camping at Mvu, the friendly lodge owners, Brett and Lynn, also allows the campers to use the rest of the lodge facilities, which includes the bar area, restaurant and the swimming pool. You can also book a boat from the lodge for a sundowner cruise or some fishing if you're into that. Needless to say, we love Mvu. It's an awesome, awesome place to come camp or stay in a lodge in the Lower Zambezi. After a wonderful night catching up with Antoinette and Dani and the kids, we were off early the next morning into the Lower Zambezi National Park using the Chongwe gate again. Lower Zambezi National Park is also a Class A National Park, which means the fees for entering the Lower Zambezi National Park is exactly the same as the fees for entering the South Luangwa National Park. Okay, time for adventure. Let's wait. After a long and eventful day in the bush, Sally and I was on the cook pots that night. We made roosterkoek and stokbrood. Sally's last night with us, and earlier in the morning, I had to take her to the Royal Airstrip, where she took a pro flight from Royal Airstrip back to Lusaka. It was sad to drop her off and see her go, but the whole bush pilot, bush flight, bush plane kind of experience was rather exciting. The flight from the Royal Airstrip back to Lusaka takes about 40 minutes. By the time Sally touched down in Lusaka, I just arrived back at Mvu camp. We had a really, really good time together for the first trip. But like everything in life, you gotta work hard to play hard. And looking forward to the next adventure together. Find my mom and dad and Antoinette and Dani still in their pajamas, just having a good time, drinking coffee and enjoying the outdoors. After we had breakfast that day, we spent the rest of the afternoon in the GMA, just enjoying the surroundings. The next morning we were up early again, and we made our way back into the Lower Zambezi National Park for a full day of exploring. Thank you. Coming to an end of an adventure is always a bittersweet experience. But we will be back and we will enjoy more of this park. This time around, we made the best of every single second, every single day. Tomorrow morning, we're going to pack up early. Antoinette and Dani is going to make their way back to Kitwe. And me and my mom and dad are going to go over the escarpment to Lusaka.
Hello followers and fans.
Say it, Ruben, say it.
Let's win.
Okay, bye.
Let's win.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Let you win.
Boy, it's just refueling me, giving me some diesel. The lower Zambezi have let us know that last night that they don't want us to go back because it was a pretty hectic night at camp. We had this young bull elephant pulling out a pipe. Later on we had two hyenas causing havoc in camp. And then when I got out to go and see if everything was okay, there was a hippo and a baby in camp as well. So that last night was certainly very, very eventful. Yes, this did happen. When you're having adventures, sometimes you do get dirty. And this is me getting dirty.
Okay, you want to take a picture?
Okay.
You want to take a picture?
No, I don't want any evidence of this. All right, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for watching. It was a wonderful experience. Mama and Papa, Antoinette and Dani, Emma and Ruben and Sally. I'm looking forward to the next adventure together.